Hello, hello everyone. Hello, amazing spiritual entrepreneurs, holistic leaders, spiritual teachers, wellness professionals. You are in the right place. Welcome to the Women's Holistic Business Network, everyone. Have you been waiting for things to line up? Have you been waiting for the perfect time to start something new in your business? Have you been waiting for there not to be some kind of catastrophe or drama or something happening either in your life or in the world? Have you been waiting for open space and clear sailing waters for you to work on your business? Have you been waiting? So that's my biggest question for you all today. Have you been waiting? Post in the comments below just the word waiting if you've been waiting. And if you're watching the replay, type the word replay in the comments down below. You are in the Women's Holistic Business Network. This is your place to get all the training, resources, and connections that you need in order to grow your business from where it is now to a place where you're reaching more people, having more fun, earning more income, and having more of an impact on the clients that you worked with and the people in the world around you. So glad to have you all here. I'm Elizabeth, the founder of the Women's Holistic Business Academy. And in the last 25 years that I've been doing business and leading and in the holistic and wellness and spirituality worlds, I have had this question come up so many times in my own life and in the lives of the women that I work with as well. When's the perfect time? Or I've got too much going on right now, or it's summertime. It's summertime, or there's something I'm dealing with in my life or my family, or all sorts of things always come up. And one thing that I know for sure is that there will always be things that come up. I've had times in my life where I've navigated massive change, massive transformation, massive pain. And I still somehow, I don't know how sometimes, but somehow I managed to keep going. So how many of you have ever had this where you've managed somehow to keep going no matter what's going on in the world? And how many of you have had this where you sometimes feel stuck or you feel frozen? If you've ever felt stuck or frozen, write that in the comments. And if you've ever managed and navigated challenging waters, let us know that in the comments as well. I want to hear from you because you are part of this incredible conversation. The past year has been intense. How many of you know that? Just type the word intense. If the past year has been intense in some way for you, how has your business shifted and changed? Where are we now? What's happening next? It's been really interesting to watch as a woman in business and just as a sensitive human being who sees and feels a lot of what's going on in the world, to watch as what we've been walking through and navigating together in our lives and our businesses in terms of this global pandemic, just watching that whole thing. And then racial injustices coming up last year, rising to the surface and being shown to all of us just a year ago. And just as the pandemic seemed to be starting to, starting to wrap up or get a handle on it, especially where I am in Canada, or for those of you who are in Northern Hemisphere, you'll be aware of this. Maybe not Northern Hemisphere, like who knows where you are in your countries. Like, let me know actually where you are and what the state is, because where we are in Canada, there's still a lot of restrictions and lockdowns happening, but they're lifting. And just as those started to lift, if you're in Canada and probably around the world, you may have heard about what the discoveries on old Indigenous residential schools, so schools where Indigenous children in Canada were forced to go, and the tragedies and abuse that happened at these is starting to rise to the surface. I mean, we've known about this, but we haven't really known about it. And it's rising to the surface lately because of the findings of the children's bodies. And that tragedy has been with me and my community for the past few weeks. The tragedy has been there for hundreds of years, but the findings, and a lot of us have been really sitting with it. And then in the wake of this celebration called Canada Day, which for those of you who are our US friends is like our 4th of July, we've realized that we can't do that to celebrate something that that really puts us in a position of, what are we doing? Like, what are we even celebrating? And for many women in our community who are Indigenous or who are Métis like me, or who have some kind of, whose hearts connect with this issue, there are protests going on all over Canada today to say, we're not celebrating a colonial system that murdered people, hundreds of thousands. And I'm not anyone to speak about this. I am not educated in this. But I want to presence this in our community, because the topic of today is, there are always things that are going to keep coming up. And we're going to have to deal with and navigate what comes up for us, and choose to take actions, choose to help and support, choose to do what we can. These things are happening in our communities right now. Now, for the last week, those of you in Western Canada, we've been having a severe, not just a heat wave, summer heat wave, but a severe heat wave, like dangerous heat, like over 40 degrees Celsius weather, which for those of you who are our American friends, this is like over 105 degrees up in Canada here, and dangerous for people. People are dying from this. So there's one thing after another right now. And then today, there's a community not all that far from where we are that's burning. So pile on extreme dry heat for the past week, and now forest fire season has started. And it just seems like our hearts and our souls are navigating one tragedy, one big thing after the other. And I'm just questioning, like, what is this all about? What is happening? Post in the comments below if you have any kind of a sense of seeing the things the way that I'm seeing them. Like, there are big things that are coming to light, and big things that are happening in our environment and in our communities, huge things. And in the midst of that, I know so many of you are navigating challenges with your families, with your children, with your partners. How many of you are navigating those kind of things right now? I'm presencing all of this because it's out there, it's in the field, it's happening. When we have our businesses, there is no wait for the perfect time because everything's gonna stop and then I'm gonna have like open space and life's not falling apart around me as I work on my business. We will be working on our businesses and working on our lives, and things will be crumbling. Injustices will come to light and we'll wanna do something about them. Cities will burn, forests will burn, we'll have to move, like, things are happening. My question to you all is, what have you done in the midst of it all? And what are you doing in the midst of it all? What are you committed to doing? What has been happening for you, and how has it been evolving for you over the past year, months, weeks? I'm not and never saying, gloss over it, ignore it, keep calm and chive on. I'm never saying that. I'm saying, let's dive in, let's hold space, let's be in the unknowing, let's be in the navigating of, like, how do we even talk about some of these things and some of these tragedies? How do we talk about all of the the mental health issues that have really risen to the surface as well in our communities and ourselves and globally because of the pandemic of the last year? Not because of it, but they've risen to the surface more, because you can't hide these things when we are in such a stressed state. Like, globally, we have been stressed. And that's why I am so committed, more committed than ever before, to supporting holistic entrepreneurs, spiritual leaders, wellness teachers, and professionals to step forward and be leaders now more than ever. Now is not a time for you to say, actually, I'm going to step back, I'm going to take the summer off, it's too easy, I'm going to take the summer off, I need to spend time with, like, myself and my family, or I'm going to take time off because there's so much tragedy and trauma coming up in the world around me that I just need to step back. And I say to you, take a deep breath. Now is not the time to step back. If you have a calling in your heart and your soul to be a leader, and I know you all do, you wouldn't be part of this group if you didn't. If you have a calling in you to be that, to be a leader now, please lean in. Do that right now. Just lean in with your body. Everybody do that with me. Just lean in with your body. Put your hand on your heart and lean in a little bit. And feel that energetic transmission of leaning in. Because when you're willing to lean in your life, in your business, no matter what is churning around you, the world can shift and change. We can make a difference. We can hold people's hands. There's something about leadership that when tragedy and trauma strikes, leadership, it can bring out the best of people. And you being that leader that you really are, and just even if you don't know what you're doing, even if you don't know what to say, even if you don't know what's happening or why or any of it, and you can still continue somehow to step forward and find your path and help other people on the path, like that is incredible. And that's what's so needed now more than ever. I was having a conversation with my incredible partner this morning about commitment and about how when we fully commit, when we fully open ourselves up and commit to something, that's when the joy and the magic and the delight and the freedom can really happen. But there's also at the same time something that is happening in our traumatized hearts and souls, that commitment's like, oh my gosh, it's scary. It's scary and we don't necessarily want to do it. It's scary. What is it going to lead to? It's scary. What am I going to have to give up? But that commitment and that leadership can help to heal the world, and healing is so important more now than it ever has been before. I'm just checking their comments because I have to look at my phone for our comments because there are so many of you. Hi, Tatina. So good to have you here. Hi, Saul. So good to have you here. Amelia, thank you for watching. I love this. Oh, yeah. Tatina, you're just a little bit south of the Canadian border. Are there fires starting up where you are yet? I love what Tatina says. This is a time of raising consciousness in the world, of leaving behind grossly outdated paradigms. I am so with you. Like, this is what I feel like what got sparked in consciousness in the 1960s had like a lag time, and people saying like, no more, like this can't happen anymore. And really it was like 50s, 60s, 70s, a lot of it, but I'm just using that as an example. Certain injustices, racial discrimination, like it was sparked. And then I look at it and I was like, it's 2021 and how are we still having such incredible ignorance? How are we still so, like, I thought that we did that, but we didn't. We sparked it. We opened the conversation. So yes. Oh my gosh, yes, Tatina, you were hot as well. I think that the wave has ended. Oh my gosh, the lie of the commonwealth is showing up. Saul says this. Saul, am I pronouncing your name right? Is it Saul or Saul? The lie of the commonwealth is showing up as the ongoing colonial systemic racism that non-Indigenous people continue to build their prosperity. Oh my gosh. Yeah. May action of relational restitution and responses take place. And this is what's happening all over my country right now. And it is so incredible. It is so powerful and so incredible, and I'm so proud of the people who are getting out there. And we're going to be doing incredible things within our community as well, and within my business. Like, my business is now at a place where I get to use it as a platform. Not like I teach launching, marketing, and speaking to spiritual entrepreneurs and to holistic practitioners who want to make a difference in the world. That's incredible. And my business is at a point now where I have an incredible team and a powerful platform that I can use to make a difference in the world as a whole. Every year I raise money, every year I give scholarships, and this year I'm more committed than ever to helping Indigenous women and women of color, and especially Indigenous women in my own community and Métis women like me. So, what can you do when your business grows? This conversation is all over the place today. There's no specific lesson, but I'm in the conversation with all of you. So what can you do when your business grows? What can you do when you have more team and more help and more income? What kind of difference can you actually make? I hope that this, I have my my phone on and it might be giving us a little bit of feedback, so I just turned that off. I also have an air conditioner on. Can you all hear that fan or is it okay? I want to make sure that you're all good. So what can you do in your business when you have influence? Type in the comments below, what kind of things do you want to be able to do with your business that's beyond the very first part of your business, which is serving your clients and making money. That's important. You have to get that filled in. And the beauty of once that's filled in, then you can actually start to reach people on a bigger level and make more of a difference. Yes, sell. There is a fund to support the Indigenous communities that are grieving. There is. I'm just going back to some of the comments. There is a fund, and maybe I could post the link here. If you want the link, just type the word link in the comments below. And I have donated to them just a week ago as well. There are people who are trained in helping people who have that specific kind of trauma in Canada. So, and I don't know what it's like in the US, but I know that the same exact problem happened. So I wonder if there's something that's going on there as well. To Tina, I love what you said. I'm committed to doing the personal work necessary so that I can hold space and support raising the consciousness of the world. Yes, 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 yes. Amy, oh my gosh, Amy, so good to have you here. Tatina says, I want to influence healthy and sustainable stewardship of this earth. I am so with you, Tatina, on that. I'm reading your incredible comments, everyone. So when your business grows, you get to steward the earth. I believe that women who are called into spiritual entrepreneurship, into being holistic healers and practitioners, counselors and people who do work directly with other people to help them heal, that there's a ripple effect that we can have. And I believe that the women who are called to do that are called for a reason, so that we can actually have that ripple effect of we work on ourselves, we do our work, and then we help our clients and our families, and we help our communities, and you see where the ripple effect continues. And then we can help our states, our provinces, or our districts, whatever, like we can make a difference, but it has to start small. And then eventually we can help our countries and our continents and our world be a better place. But it has to start with us finding our way into our own health and our own sustainability. And there are some things there, like one, incredible self-care and self-awareness and self-work. We always have to be working on our internal healing. It doesn't have to be easy, but it's for our healing. Working on that and working on our leadership within our businesses is one of the most incredible things that we can do. So how are you working on your leadership in particular? Are you taking leadership training? Are you taking business training? Are you pouring into yourself so that you can be a vessel and a light that radiates out into your community as we work on these things? How can you do that? Oh yeah. So by the way, I wrote in today's topic, have you been waiting for things to line up? Have you been waiting for things to be perfect? I want to address this as well. Because here we are, we're having this amazing conversation. And some of you are here live, and Amy and Amelia and Tatina and Saul are here live, and a bunch of others are here live. And some of you are watching the replay, and I'm chatting with you as well in the replay. We're here and we're working on things, and life is happening all around us. And sometimes that can lead to a situation where we go, I'll wait until the pandemic is over to start my business. I'll wait until my community isn't grieving about the findings at the residential schools to work on my business. I'll wait until my relationship sorts itself out. I'll wait until my family does this. I'll wait until my health sorts itself out. I'll wait until, how many of you, I'm saying these things for all of you, how many of you have ever told yourself these stories that you're going to wait? So you've got this big vision. You want to help the earth. Amelia wants to inspire community to make healthier choices for themselves and their environment. You have big visions. You have your heart calling you. And yet, is there a part of you that's still waiting for the ducks to line up, for the stars to align, for the next full moon, for Monday, for tomorrow? And what I say is, as we can see what's happening in the world around us, and it just became so apparent to me, like this happened, then this happened, then this happened, and then I woke up this morning and the sky was full of smoke again, massive fires. And it's like, when are we gonna stop waiting? The world needs you now. The world needs spiritual entrepreneurs who have a heart and a soul to guide the way. It's no accident that entrepreneurship has become so big. I've been an entrepreneur for 25 years, and I have watched a surge over the past 5 years of women saying, I need to start a business. I want to start my business. I want to finally get out there. Or women who have been practitioners for the last 10 or 20 years saying, I need to get online. I need to reach more people. And there's no accident about this. Like, we are rising for a reason. We're rising for a reason. Your heart is calling you, and it's obvious with everything that's happening in the world, and it's not stopping. So don't wait for things to line up. Don't wait for perfection. Just go for completion. Don't wait for you to feel ready or comfortable or aligned, because you won't, because the part of you that is the old you, that old paradigm part of you, and I know you all have it, that small self that wants to keep you down, that ego self that's like really scared, that will always come up with excuses. And the further you are along on your spiritual path, get this, the trickier that voice gets. That ego voice that's like, oh, this doesn't feel quite right. This doesn't feel aligned. I don't know. But meanwhile, greater spirit is calling you and saying, do something about this now. The world needs you more than ever. And you're like, yes. And then little ego's like, but I'm so scared. How many of you have that? Post in the comments down below right now if you have that, like that push-pull, that like, I want to do big things. I want to help people. And I don't mean that you've got to like write a book and shout it from the rooftops. I just mean you standing in you, standing for the people that you're here to help, and whatever that looks like for how your individual journey looks. I'm here to stand that you all pull yourselves towards the light that's calling, because it's needed now more than it ever has been before. And you can do this, and you can get trainings and tools and systems and all the things that will help to pull you forward. I like that Amy wrote, don't wait for perfection, just go for completion. Yes, I love that so much. So keep on writing in your comments, everyone. So how do you sustainably grow your business? How do you navigate your entrepreneurial journey no matter what is happening? How do you continue on the path? How do you keep going? In my experience, it's always this push-pull battle, and it's keep your eye on your vision. So take a deep breath. Some of you wrote in what that vision was. Titania and Amelia were writing in what their vision was, and it was coming out of their heart just really naturally. Write down what your vision is, everyone. Write it in the chat right now, because when you write it to other people and to community, oh my gosh, it becomes more real and more tangible. So your vision becoming more real and more tangible is one of those things to pull you forward. Even when it's hitting the fan around you, when it's big things happening, great injustices that you want to do something about, your business can be the point that actually provides change in your world and in your community. And that is incredible. So what is your vision? What is it that you want to do? And let your vision be greater than you. Let your vision be greater than your mind can even think. And your vision can be about what you want to create for the world. And also include in that vision, I like to have a four-part vision, include in that vision what you want for the world, and also what you want for your family, what you want for your clients, and what you want for your own soul, your own heart, and your own life. All those four parts are necessary when you create a vision, because all of them filled in are important. Sometimes people will have a vision, I just want to do this thing in the world, and then it's like, but it's there's an emptiness on the other side of it if you don't have all those four parts filled out for the world, for your community, for your family, and for yourself. Somebody write that down. Oh, I like what Amelia wrote here. The deception of that little ego voice is so tricky. Yes, it's the push-pull. Hey, Trina, good to have you here. How are you? Trina's been doing incredible things in the world lately with Visionary Leaders. How's your series been going, Trina, by the way? So many brave women are around me right now. Some of the women who are in my training programs are just bravely opening their hearts and moving forward together because they know what they're up to is going to make a difference to their communities, their families, the people in their lives, to their own lives, and eventually, ultimately, to this world that we live in and this planet that we live on. And it starts with you actually being brave and being courageous and doing something in the world, and for your business. And your business is more important to work on now than ever. It might be so easy, this whole conversation is around this. It might be so easy to say, well, maybe I shouldn't work on it. You know, it's summertime, there's forest fires, there's the beach to go to, there's relationships falling apart, there are community tragedies, there are, you name it. What's going on in your life right now? Let's presence it. Put it in the chat if you feel safe and comfortable, and you are safe and comfortable. What's going on in your life that could be the thing that holds you back? Type it in the chat right now, and we're going to hold you as you type it in the chat. What could be the thing that holds you back? For me, one of the things that could be the thing that holds me back is I'm a highly sensitive person and highly intuitive. And so when there are traumas and tragedies going on in my community, in the world, with friends, with family, I feel it so deeply. And it might make me go, I'm just going to lay right here for like the next week and do nothing. That could be the thing that holds me back. And so when I presence it here with you all, I go, and I'm not going to. I'm going to give myself the space to feel. I'm going to surround myself with support. I'm going to talk to my incredible guy. I'm going to do what I need to lift myself up, and I'm going to show up and be of service to all of you, to the incredible women in my program. I'm going to show up and be of service, because when I'm of service, that has a ripple effect that's going to change the world. So what is it that might hold you back, and what is it that you know as a leader is going to help you? Oh, Amelia, thank you so much for your vulnerability. She writes, fear of failure. How many of the rest of you have fear of failure? Put a little heart by Amelia's comment, because she was the first one to write it. And I know that there are so many of you that are going to be writing in as the replay is running and as the rest of you are mustering your courage. How many of the rest of you have fear of failure? Put a heart by that. And as any other women write what might get in the way for them, will you put a heart by their comment? And what that does is it lets them know that they're not alone. We put a heart across the screen right now for me. Because when we know we are not alone and we can stop lone wolfing, we can actually do greater things. And that's one of the remedies here for any of this stuff, like waiting for if it's perfect, having stress and trauma come up in your life, having all the things is waiting for perfection, waiting for it, and isolating yourself to feed that loop. Stop being alone. Be as brave as what Amelia just did with writing that comment in. And as soon as you do that, there's something about it that melts. Everyone take a deep breath right now and let it out. Isn't there something that melts it when we share it? And women who are leaders, women who are entrepreneurs, spiritual teachers, we need this network of support and encouragement more than ever, because we're coming out of a paradigm of isolation and fear of other women. Let's drop that and let's be in this together. Who's with me? Just type the word together if you're with me. I like what Tatina, I love what you wrote here. Hopelessness holds me back because it feels like there's so much to do and I don't have enough energy. Oh, I put a heart by yours as well. I'm going to do it right now because I'm asking you all, put a heart. Can I do that on my phone right now? Let me see. Anyway, I might have to do it after. I'm trying to do it on my after for Tatina and Amelia's comments. Like, how many of the rest of you have that hopelessness? It holds you back. And also feeling like there's so much to do. It might be a feeling of overwhelm as well. Is that true for you, Tatina? I know I have that. That feeling of overwhelm that comes up. There's so much to do and you don't have enough energy. Like it's like there's so much to do. So how many of the rest of you have that as well? That hopelessness could be a thing that holds you back. And now take leadership. What exactly is it are you going to do to make sure that these things that could rise up and take you over and take you down and take you out and make you not make a difference in the world, what will you do to make sure that they don't? So step one is just outing it, just like you did right here. It's just calling it out. Sometimes I like to write a note to myself, like, dear Elizabeth, remember this. don't stop. Don't stop no matter what. I have this thing that I developed also. I called it stop, drop, and roll. I developed this a couple of years ago. You remember that thing that we all learned when we were kids, stop, drop, and roll, like if a fire happens or if you get lit on fire, stop, drop, and roll. I think of that emotionally with energy. So if I have a fear thought coming up or a negative thought coming up, I'll stop. I'll drop it and I'll roll into a new thought. And I replace it. I literally sometimes have to replace it with rainbows and butterflies, which is going to sound funny to you because it's like, oh, I'm not saying be fake. I'm not saying go rainbows and butterflies on everything. But sometimes when our minds go into the spin of overwhelm and negativity and self-deprecation and the things that aren't going to make a difference in our businesses and let us be of service, that we have to stop and drop those things and roll into something new and different. So that's a tip for you all. So what else do you have? What do you all do? I want to hear from you now. Post in the comments down below right now. What do you do when you find yourself having excuses, when you find yourself in overwhelm, when you find yourself waiting too long, waiting for things to be perfect, and you go, oh my gosh, I was here a year ago and I didn't make the change I promised myself. What are you gonna do now? What is it that's going to help you? And for me, one of the things that helps me is I look at what's going on the planet and world with all the things that we were talking about earlier, and I'm going, there's no time to continue in complacency and self-doubt. Like, we have to continue to bravely step forward and to do it for each other, to do it for our families, our communities, our clients, countries, the world. Like, there's something at play that's so much bigger, and that's our vision for making the world a better place. And you can do that through your business. Like, this is your business is a pathway to make the world a better place, to evolve you and your heart and your soul and your spirit in such a huge way. Like, there are incredible things that you can do because of the work that you do in the world. So if you ever have those doubts coming up, if you ever feel like, well, I don't want to work on my business right now, take a deep breath, do it right now, and tell yourself, now's the time. Now's my time. No more holding back. Well, let's do this together. I love what Amy wrote. Yes, Amelia likes to stop, drop, and roll. Yes, Tatina, it does feel like overwhelm. Amy wrote here, every moment is a new chance to shift your thoughts. Every moment is a new chance to shift your thought, and every moment is a new chance to continue to open yourself up and work on your business. Now's the best time. So don't let yourself get trapped by the, but it's summertime. Yeah, you're going to be doing stuff anyway. If you are scrolling social media, you have time to work on your business. If you are doing things that aren't healthy, you know what they are. I don't know what they are. You know what they are. If you're doing things that are not healthy or productive, you have time to work on your business. If you have time to watch Netflix, you have time to work on your business. If you have time to watch movies, you have time to work on your business. If you have time to, what are the things that you do? And you know you do them. I'm calling a few of you out right now. What are the things that you do that you're putting it in the way and those are your excuses? Is it family members that are excuses? Is it money that's your excuse? Is it time? And how can you call yourself out? Because you're all leaders here. How can you call yourself out on those things that you're doing and say, now's the time. Now more than ever, we're needed. Now's the time. So let's keep this conversation going. I want to hear from you. What are the things that you do? What are the shifts that you would put into place? And one of those biggest shifts that I put in is that, remember, it's holding on to your vision, creating that vision, and let it be big. Let your vision be bigger than your overwhelm. Let your vision be bigger than any of your excuses. Give yourself timelines. Call yourself out if you're like, oh, if I'm watching another Netflix series in like one day, I do have time to work on my business and time to be of service. Amelia, money is a huge excuse. If money is a huge excuse for the rest of you, how many of the rest of you have it? So many, I bet. Now it means your business is more important to work on than ever because your business is what's going to bring you money. Amy, time is my biggest excuse. The more you work on your business, everyone, the more time, I know it sounds like a paradox, the more time you will have because your business will give you freedom. It will give you time freedom, but it requires you to work on it. It requires you to give your time to it. If you want time to be given to you, you need to give time to the things that matter to you. I love doing excuse melting. There's got to be a better word for that, but excuse melting. Who else has one? I've got your back. This is so good. Oh my gosh, Titina was going. She's going to connect with a reporter who interviewed her during Earth Day while she was doing a cleanup. Titina, you're incredible. Our community is amazing and does really incredible things. So keep doing what you're doing. Okay. You're all amazing. This has been a really fun conversation. Really enjoyed it. Post in the comments below, what have you gotten out of this? What are you walking away with? And what is your recommendation? What are your ideas for the other women in this community? Because it's not just one voice here. We are all the voices. I'm going to sign off. Keep working on your business. You're also incredible. Keep working on your business, because when you do, we truly make the world a better place together. I'll see you all really soon. And stay cool and stay in your heart. And I'll see you next time. Bye, everybody.